Traffic Entertainment.
The snow is melting, and with the spring will come a new wave of migration. What can we expect from Europe? Well, let's do a quick overview of what has happened so far. In 2015, a little over 1 million migrants entered Europe, numbers unlike anything we had seen in past years. The international media cheered on this intake of refugees with rose-colored glasses on, and countries around the globe were pressured to increase their promised intake of refugees as their populaces cheered on the prospect. The excitement didn't last long, though, as videos started arising of the situation in Europe. And when we took away our eyes from the numbers charts, real people were suffering under what in their lives literally looked like an invasion. Towns of 100 people in Germany were accepting 750 migrants to them, leaving it up to the German people to assimilate to the migrants and not the other way around. Crime, rape, and terrorism surged across Europe in all forms, with hatchet attacks, knife attacks, and later on trucks and bombs. And the people said no more. People took to the streets to protest, walls were built in Eastern Europe, and migrant enthusiastic politicians began walking back their insane policies. And of course, how can we forget about Brexit? By the time we hit 2016, we had a year of horrifying terrorism and sexual assault cases revealed in Germany, Sweden, and France. And the narrative surrounding refugees took a stark turn. In the first 5 months of 2016, the amount of migrants entering Europe had already exceeded the first 5 months of 2015. Now back to the current year, 2017, the world has been focused on Donald Trump and the battles in America. But as Sweden burns and riots, the world's eyes have turned back to the heart of the West and what lies ahead for it. So what can we expect in 2017 for migrants? Well, predictions are not looking good for Europe. Just recently, a leaked secret report from the German security authorities showed that almost 6 million migrants in countries around the Mediterranean are looking to enter Europe. 2.93 million from Turkey, 1.2 million from Libya, 720,000 from Jordan. Then, of course, Africans, predominantly from Niger and Mali, have gone to Algeria and Libya in preparation to make their move. Most of these migrants will be taking routes to the Greek islands and then to central Greece or to Italy, then making their way from those points to the countries that are rumored to have the most welfare. Some migrants have already attempted to make an early move on Europe, but were met with the harsh cold of a winter journey, resulting in migrants freezing to death on their trip. The larger waves should start coming in a few months as the temperature rises. With this immediate threat on the heels of Europe, politicians are making their predictions for the spring and summer. Hungary's chief security advisor to Viktor Orban stated that illegal migration will remain a significant issue this year, and the situation could in fact worsen in 2017. He continued, stating that, "In my view, the EU measures are insufficient to stop illegal migration, including the setting up of a joint EU border and coast guard. Hungary has built two walls and is working with countries like Croatia to seal off all of the different migrant routes." The Prime Minister of Malta, Joseph Muscat, has also stated that come next spring, the number of people crossing over the Mediterranean will reach record levels. He continues, "The choice is trying to do something now or meeting urgently in April and May and try to do a deal then." The kind of deal he's talking about is likely one with Turkey, in which they help control the flow of migrants in exchange for euros. President of the European Parliament, Antonio Tajani, has also told media that if situations in Africa continue to get worse, we will have millions and millions of Africans pushing to enter Europe, and dams and walls will not be sufficient to hold them back. By the looks of it, what many initially thought was an easy-to-respond-to humanitarian crisis has now turned into a battle for the European identity and for its physical survival as well. The welfare state is not infinite, and the social systems that once supported the European people have become so generous with strangers they are now unsustainable for themselves. And even worse, the social situation in Europe is beyond on thin ice. It cracked long ago. How much more can they take? Predictions past 2017 suggest that migrants will be coming in the tens of millions. And it's going to take more than just a few nationalistic Eastern European countries banding together to stop that. The spring of 2017 is going to be a deciding moment for politicians and voters across Europe on whether they believe in the sovereignty of their nation states or whether they will sacrifice their cultures, freedoms, and identity in an act of pathological altruism. I'm so far out of sight. Yeah, that sounds about right.
Mixed.